In this class, we are going to discuss about qualifiers in C language. Qualifiers can also be called as modifiers also. So qualifiers or modifiers in C language. So qualifiers are mainly useful in order to change the meaning of basic data types. So if we want to change the meaning of basic data types, then we use either qualifiers or modifiers. In C language, there are four types of qualifiers are available. The first qualifier is size qualifier. Qualifier can also be called as modifier also. And the second qualifier is sign qualifier. Third one is const qualifier. Fourth one is volatile qualifier. So size qualifier, sign qualifier, const qualifier and volatile qualifier. So let's see about the first one. The first one is size qualifier. It is mainly useful in order to change the size of the basic data type. So the name itself specifies the meaning. If we want to change the size of basic data type, then we use size qualifier. There are two types of size qualifiers are available. The first one is short qualifier. Second one is long qualifier. Short qualifier reduces the size of the basic data type or keeps the size as it is, whereas long qualifier increases the size of the basic data type. If you take int, if size of the integer is 2 bytes, then the size of the long int will become 4 bytes. So that means the long qualifier is increasing the size of the basic data type. Okay. So likewise, if you take the size of the double as 4 bytes, then the size of the long double will become 8 bytes. So if size of the double is 8 bytes, then the size of the long double will become 10 bytes. So that means the long qualifier is increasing the size of the double. So we can say that long qualifier increases the size of the basic data type, whereas short qualifier keeps the size same or decreases the size of the basic data type. If size of the integer is 2 bytes, then the size of the short int is 2 bytes or 1 byte. That depends upon the compiler. If you take Turbo C, then the size of the short int is 2 bytes. Whereas if you take Linux operating system, some VI editor, then the size of the short int is 1 byte. So that means short qualifier decreases or keep the size same. So that is about size qualifier. So we have two types of size qualifiers, short qualifier and long qualifier. So now let's see about the second type of qualifier. So what is the second type of qualifier? Sign qualifier. Here there are two types of sign qualifiers are available. First one is, now we are discussing about sign qualifier. First one is signed qualifier. Second one is unsigned qualifier. So what is the first one? Signed qualifier. The name itself specifies the meaning. Signed qualifier means there is a sign before the corresponding value. So the value may be either positive sign or negative sign. So plus value or minus value. So that means signed qualifier allows us to store both positive value as well as negative value. Whereas unsigned qualifier, the name itself specifies the meaning. Unsigned means there is no sign before the corresponding value. If there is no sign before the corresponding value, then the default sign is plus. So if you take the constant value as 10, here there is no sign before 10. So then the default sign will become positive. That means plus. So unsigned qualifier allows us to store only positive values. Whereas signed qualifier allows us to store both positive and negative values. Now let's see what is the range of the signed qualifier and unsigned qualifier. So first let us calculate range of unsigned qualifier. Range of unsigned qualifier. Unsigned qualifier means we stores only positive values. Okay. Let n is equal to 3 bits. Here n represents number of bits. Then the total number of numbers that we can store is 2 power 3 numbers. So if the number of bits are 3, then the number of positive numbers that we can store is 2 power 3. So 2 power 3 means, so totally we can store 8 numbers. 8 numbers. 8 positive numbers. The minimum positive number is 0. Whereas the maximum positive number, here how many numbers we can store? 8 numbers. So 0 is the first number. So what is the last number? 7 is the last number. If 1 is the first number, then 8 will becomes the last number. So here if you take n as 3 bits, then how many positive numbers we can store? N is equal to 3. So we can store 2 power 3 numbers. So 2 power 3 means 8 numbers. So the minimum positive number is 0. Here how many numbers we can store? 8 numbers. So from 0 to 7. So 0 means first number, 1 means second number, 2 means third number, next 3 means fourth one, next 4 means fifth one, 5 means sixth one, 6 means seventh one, and 7 means eighth number. So likewise, if you take n as 4 bits, then how many numbers, how many integer numbers we can store? 2 power 4 integer numbers. 2 power 4 is nothing but 16. So we can store 16 positive numbers. So from 0 to 15. So 0 to 7. So this can be written as 0 to 2 power 3 minus 1. Here also we can write as 0 to 2 power. Here what is n value? 4. So 2 power 4 minus 1. Here what is 3? 3 is nothing but n. Here what is 4? 4 is nothing but n. So this can be written as 0 to 2 power n minus 5. So this is nothing but the range of unsigned qualifier. So the range of unsigned qualifier is 0 to 2 power n minus 1. 0 to 2 power n minus 1. Okay. Now let us calculate range of the signed qualifier. Range of the signed qualifier. So range of signed qualifier. So signed means we can store both positive numbers as well as negative numbers. So if you take n as 3 bits, then how many numbers we can store? 2 power 3 numbers, because n means 3. So 2 power 3 is nothing but 8. So we can store 8 numbers. So out of 8 numbers, the first 4 are nothing but negative numbers. The next 4 are nothing but positive numbers. So what are the 4 negative numbers here? Minus 1. Minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Next, 4 positive numbers. So minimum positive integer is 0. Next, 1, 2, 3. So these are nothing but 4 positive numbers. These are nothing but 4 negative numbers. So what is the minimum value? Minus 4. What is the maximum value? 3. So minus 4 to 3. So this is nothing but range here. So likewise, if you take n as 4, then how many numbers we can store? 2 power 4. We can store 2 power 4 numbers. So 2 power 4 is nothing but 16 numbers. So out of 16, the first 8 are nothing but negative numbers. The next 8 are nothing but positive numbers. So minus 8 to 2. So from minus 8 to minus 1. So 8 negative numbers. And minus 8 to minus 1. So these are nothing but negative numbers. First 8 negative numbers. And the minimum positive integer is 0. 0 to totally 8 positive numbers. So 0 to 7. So what is the range here? Minus 8 to 7. Minus 4 to 3. So minus 2 power. Here what is n value? 3 is nothing but n value. Okay. So this is nothing but minus 2 power 3 minus 1, 2. 2 power 3 minus 1, minus 1. So minus 2 power, what is n value here? N is nothing but 3. So 3 minus 1 means 2. So minus 2 square. So minus 2 square is nothing but minus 4. 2. 2 power 3 minus 1 is nothing but 2. So 2 power 3 minus 1. So 2 power 2. So 2 power 2 means 4. So 4 minus 1 is nothing but 3. So minus 2 power. So what is 3 here? 3 is nothing but n value. So minus 2 power n minus 1 to 2 power n minus 1 minus 1. So likewise here also we can write the same thing. So minus 2 power here 3. What is n value? 4. So 4 minus 1. So 4 minus 1 means 3. So minus 2 power 3 means 8. So 2. 2 power n minus 1 means 8. So 8 minus 1 means minus 1. So what is the range of the sign qualifier? Minus 2 power n minus 1 to 2 power n minus 1 minus 1. So in this way we can calculate the range of unsigned and signed qualifier. So now let's see the next one. So what is the next one? The next type of qualifier is Cornish qualifier. So now let's see about Cornish qualifier. So by using Cornish qualifier, we can maintain a variable as constant. So if you want to maintain a variable as a constant, then we can use a Cornish variable. The major difference between a variable and constant is the value of a variable may changes during program execution, whereas the value of constant cannot changes during program execution. Now let's see how we can define a constant. We can define a constant using a keyword, a qualifier called const. So const space data type. Here specifying the data type is not compulsory, it is optional. Data type. Next, variable is equal to value. Now let's see some example. Const, let data type is int. Let name of the variable is a. A is equal to, let the value of the variable is 10. Okay. So whenever we declared a variable like this, then a will become const variable. So whenever a variable is declared as const, then it is not possible to change this value in the program execution. So throughout the program, a value should be 10 only. So it's not possible to change this const value. Okay. If we try to change a value, then the compiler will generate error messages. Here, for a const variable, initialization should be performed during declaration only. So during declaration only, we have to perform the initialization. Okay. Now let's take an example. So main function. So const. So let the data type is int. Name of the variable is a is equal to 10. Next we display a value. Printf slash n a is equal to percentage d comma a. So program execution starts from main function. So what is a value? 10. So a value will be printed. So output of this program is a is equal to. So what is a value? 10 will be printed. So let us write one more statement here. A is equal to 20. Now let's see what will happen. So here a is declared as a const variable. So it is not possible to change a value. So if we try to change a value, then what will happen? Then the compiler will generate error message. So an error message will be printed. Cannot modify const. So this is about const qualifier. So what is the advantage of the const qualifier? If you declare a variable as const, then it's not possible to change its value in the program. So throughout the program, the variable value should be this one, 10 only. Okay. Now let's see the last qualifier, volatile qualifier. We can change volatile qualifier value from outside the program, such as interrupts. So in the program, it's not possible to change volatile qualifier value. So if we want to change volatile variable value, then we have to write some other program. The best example is interrupt. So with the help of an interrupt, we can change volatile variable value. So this is about qualifiers. So swice qualifier, sign qualifier, const qualifier, volatile qualifier. So swice qualifier changes the size of the basic data type. Sign qualifier, by using sign qualifier, we can store only positive values, or we can store both positive and negative values. If we want to store only positive values, then we use just unsigned qualifier. If we want to store both positive and negative values, then we use a signed qualifier. Okay. Const qualifier means its value never changes during program execution. Volatile qualifier means its value can be changes from outside the program with the help of interrupts. So this is about qualifiers or modifiers in C language.